Good morning. Today we are going to demonstrate how the direction of the force of friction opposes sliding motion.
Flipping physics.
Class, there are three things I asked you to remember about the direction of the force of friction. What are they?
The direction of the force of friction is parallel to the two surfaces.
It opposes sliding motion.
It is independent of the direction of the force applied.
Correct. Now, we have already had several lessons where we discussed and demonstrated those three things. However, today I want to further demonstrate what it means that the direction of the force of friction opposes sliding motion. So, if a block is sliding to the right, the force of kinetic friction from the table on the block is to the left. The force of kinetic friction opposes the sliding motion. And before the block slides to the right, there is still a force of tension pulling the block to the right. However, the block is not yet moving. In other words, in the absence of a force of static friction, the block would slide to the right. Therefore, the force of static friction from the table on the block is to the left. The force of static friction opposes the sliding the block would do if the force of static friction were not there. Bobby, please explain all of that if the directions were reversed.
Okay, if a block is sliding to the left, the force of kinetic friction from the table on the block is to the right. The force of kinetic friction opposes the sliding motion, and before the block slides to the left, there is still a force of tension pulling the block to the left. In other words, in the absence of a force of static friction, the block would slide to the left. Therefore, the force of static friction from the table on the block is to the right. The force of static friction opposes the sliding the block would do if the force of static friction were not there.
Exactly.
I feel like we have basically already discussed these demonstrations, right?
Sure. But now let's make it a little bit more complicated by placing a disc on top of the block and discuss the direction of the force of friction from the block on the disc. Yeah. If a disc is on a block while the block is moving to the left, and the disc is sliding to the right relative to the block, the force of kinetic friction from the block on the disc is to the left. Again, the force of kinetic friction opposes the sliding motion of the disc relative to the block.
I don't get it. You can clearly see the disc is moving to the left in the video. If the disc is moving to the left, how can the force of kinetic friction also be to the left? I thought the force of friction opposes sliding motion.
Okay, sure. Let's motion track the video to make the block stationary in the video. That makes it so we can observe the motion of the disc relative to the motion of the block. Now you can see that the disc is moving to the right relative to the block. The force of kinetic friction opposes the sliding motion between the two surfaces. So only the motion of the object relative to the surface matters for determining the direction of the force of friction. If a disc is on a block, and the disc is sliding to the right relative to the block, the force of kinetic friction from the block on the disc is to the left. Again, the force of kinetic friction opposes the sliding motion of the disc relative to the block. But let's go back to looking at this relative to a stationary observer. Notice the disc is moving to the left relative to a stationary observer. However, that is irrelevant. As far as the direction of the force of kinetic friction is concerned, only the motion of the object relative to the surface that object is touching matters. Also notice, in this case, this means the force of kinetic friction and the velocity of the object relative to a stationary observer are in the same direction. That is why this example can be confusing for students. But remember, as far as the direction of the force of kinetic friction is concerned, only the motion of the object relative to the surface matters.
Mr. P?
Yes, Billy?
I'm sorry, however, I still do not really see why the force of kinetic friction is to the left on the disc in this case. Go back to the motion track video that makes the block stationary, and get rid of the table for a second, and it looks like the disc is accelerating to the right, so there has to be a net force acting to the right to cause that acceleration, right? I mean, Newton's second law states that net force equals mass times acceleration, where both force and acceleration are vectors, so there has to be a net force acting to the right on the disc, yeah?
Yeah.
That is a fair question, Billy. There is a condition which must be met for Newton's second law to be true, which we clearly do not talk about often enough. Anybody remember what it is?
Inertial reference frames. Newton's second law is only valid in inertial reference frames. Newton's second law is only valid in reference frames where with zero acceleration.
Yeah, and the block is accelerating to the left. So the reference frame of the block is a non-inertial reference frame.
And that means Newton's second law is not valid in this reference frame.
Yeah, that is why the disk accelerates to the right without a net external force in this reference frame, because this is a non-inertial reference frame. Cool.
Yeah, but I'm still not completely following why the force of kinetic friction is to the left on the disk in this case.
Okay. What if I just slide a disk to the right on the table? Do you see how the force of kinetic friction from the table is to the left on the disk because the disk is sliding to the right relative to the table?
Yeah.
And that the force of kinetic friction from the block is to the left on the disk because the disk is sliding to the right relative to the block?
Yeah, that makes sense. Thanks for the clarification.
Actually, if we go back to looking at the block and disk in the stationary reference frame of the table, which is an inertial reference frame because it is not accelerating, you could see the disk accelerates to the left, therefore there must be a net force in the x direction acting on the disk to the left to cause that acceleration.
So the force of kinetic friction must be to the left on the disk to cause a net force to the left, which accelerates the disk to the left. All right, now it makes more sense. Thanks.
You are welcome.
Yeah, you are welcome. Okay, let's reverse the directions, and Billy, please explain this.
Absolutely. If a disk is on a block while the block is moving to the right, and the disk is sliding to the left relative to the block, the force of kinetic friction from the block on the disk is to the right. Again, the force of kinetic friction opposes the sliding motion of the disk relative to the block, and if we motion track the video to make the block stationary in the video, that makes it so we can observe the motion of the disk relative to the motion of the block. Now you can definitely see that the disk is moving to the left relative to the block. The force of kinetic friction opposes the sliding motion between the two surfaces, so only the motion of the object relative to the surface matters for determining the direction of the force of friction. If a disk is on a block and the disk is sliding to the left relative to the block, the force of kinetic friction from the block on the disk is to the right. Again, the force of kinetic friction opposes the sliding motion of the disk relative to the block. Yeah.
Thank you, Billy. I do have one more thing I want to point out. The force of friction, just like all other forces, is the result of an interaction between two objects. So far, we have only looked at the force of friction from the block on the disk. Realize in each instance, there is always, according to Newton's third law, an equal but opposite force of friction acting from the disk on the block. For example, when the block is sliding to the right, the force of kinetic friction from the block on the disk is to the right. There is also, simultaneously, a force of kinetic friction from the disk on the block, which is to the left. Newton's third law. The force of kinetic friction from the block on the disk is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction to the force of kinetic friction from the disk on the block. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.